Hi, I'm Anna Hoffman, and welcome to this episode of Data Exposed. I'm here in the studios with Bob Ward. Bob, thanks so much for joining me today.
We're here again.
We are
together
here
in the studio.
Again.
Great to be here.
Great to have you. And today we're going to be talking about Azure OpenAI and some of the recent enhancements we've done with Azure SQL Database or things that just work. So Bob, what have you got for us today?
Let's do demos. I think so.
Okay.
Some stuff people haven't probably seen before.
Uh-huh.
So let's show it off. The first thing I want to show you is a new experience where we're going to use the combination of SQL with OpenAI to do some chatting.
Chat. Okay. Yeah, let's do it.
Let me show you. So Anna, we're going to first show you how to integrate SQL with OpenAI through a very interesting concept called REST API integration. You've seen a little bit before, but maybe not in this way. So first of all, what we've done is we've indexed our order reviews with Azure Cognitive Services. So in order to do that, we put it in ACS, index it, and now we can do chats with our data. So I've got some example questions here I'm showing you. I'm going to paste them in there, and I'm going to go get some information about reviews of our scooters and our product. Now, you might can do some sentiment search with full text search or something to get answers like that, but to get a chat session like this is kind of hard to do.
Cool.
So it's showing me the answer and a citation for exactly what that negative sentiment was. That might not seem that complicated, but let's do something a little bit more complicated. Let's actually go and see how can we improve our scooters. So now it's going after several different reviews and looking at ones that are not just negative, but also ones that maybe show a slightly positive sentiment, but also have a suggestion. So let me scroll down and show you what that looks like. Yeah, several different reviews have come back, some negative, some positive, but also with suggestions on how to improve our product. This
Wow.
would be very difficult to do this just to search on your review database. This is over like a trillion row table.
Wow,
so
that's awesome.
It is. Now, that's interesting to do in a chat playground. But what about SQL? So we've built a stored procedure to do the same thing.
What?
In the engine, I know.
You can just ask your questions?
Yeah, so I'm answering the question to the stored procedure. I'm gonna get back the same results I got back before with the answer about the reviews and the actual citations. Pretty cool.
Wow, yep.
I got more. I'm gonna show you the code for this procedure.
Okay.
So we're gonna use the new REST API integration story to be the way to interact with OpenAI, just like the chat playground. So I've got information about ACS here and our indexes, and I'm telling the AI assistant for OpenAI how to interact with me. Now here is the key. It's the new REST API integration inside the engine, and the REST endpoint is OpenAI. The payload's the question. So I love this idea because now instead of building like a chatbot, I can do it securely in the SQL engine now and get the same experience that you get from generative AI from things like chat sessions.
Wow, that is super impressive. And then I love the part here where it says like you tell the role that they have
yeah.
there.
You give suggestions to the AI bot or the OpenAI on how to actually interact with
yeah,
it. So, yeah,
exactly. Awesome. That is super cool and something people can take advantage today because of this SP invoke external REST endpoint.
Exactly.
Right?
Exactly.
Okay, awesome. Cool. So now I know we've
got
more.
I got another one. Have you ever heard of prompt flow?
I haven't.
Okay. This is an example of prompt flow. Let me go through and kind of walk you through this. This is a new thing in an AI learning studio. What I do is I build several prompts for like a chatbot session based on queries of my SQL data. And my goal here is to actually integrate a chat in my application. But I first am going to use prompts to do it. Now, over the left-hand side here, you can see these prompts. This is Python code that I've built to connect to the database and run specific queries to go get information about my products, my orders. My end goal is to build a chat for a customer to interact with our database, like on our website, which is pretty cool. And I'm going to use this prompt flow system to make all that work. So the other thing I can do here as part of this prompt flow, though, is just like you saw before, I'm going to give a chat session, like in a test environment inside the prompt flow. So I can kind of do some basic testing. Now, what's really interesting, notice it's based on sales data. Customers don't have access to our sales data. But we can actually have an interactive chat session with a customer to give him insights on that information. It would be hard for him to do. Now, another thing that's important is to give instructions to the chatbot, OpenAI, about how to interact with the customer. And these are these instructions about, hey, I want you to interact in this kind of way with the chatbot.
You give these instructions in plain text.
In plain text, yeah, as part of the prompt flow.
What?
So I'm designing the entire chat experience based on queries and directions to the AI assistant. So let's go test it. So I can have something called an endpoint once I've built this. The endpoint is what the app will use to actually generate the chat. Now to test this, I'm going to put in like a customer in our database.
Mm.
So let's assume Donald Blanton is interacting with our chat and he wants to know new jerseys for his customers. So it's very context sensitive to Donald about his current purchases or his previous purchases. and our current sales data. So we're actually showing you what it would look like for Donald to interact with our chat on our website. And it's showing information about what he purchased in the past, what his preferences are, and again, though, based on sales data, recommendations for him to consider what new jerseys might be applicable for his customers.
Wow.
It gets even better. So I'm going to put another one here that's really interesting. So let's go and put this in here. Let me go get this. Oh, yeah. What are the most popular bikes? Now, you could try to use a ranking system or reviews from customers. But again, we're going to use our sales data to give him insights on what we are seeing as a company that he might be interested in. And again, it's very context sensitive. So it's going to, we know he's usually purchases mountain bikes for our company. And it's going to give him detailed information about the different bikes, sizes, prices, frames, things that he knows as an expert in the bike industry about what he would do.
Wow, that's really impressive. It's, now, I got to ask you a question. Like, what's the plumbing that you have to do to get this to work?
Yeah, you just go into the designer studio and build these prompts with your code to access queries, and you kind of design a flow for how those prompts will work. And behind the scenes, we will use Agnative Cognitive Services to go look at our data in our SQL database to make this work.
Gotcha. So like probably the biggest part is just making sure you have the right instructions in plain text.
Yeah, you get the right instructions in the AI system, but also how to build those prompts, you know, for the different queries. Now, one of the things to show you is this called batch runs. I'd like to do some testing of various types of input into the prompt flow and see how it's going to look overall for our customers. So this batch runs allows us to do like kind of like you would expect, like batch testing for different types of inputs. And you can see here, I'm giving different customer names, different types of questions, and it's coming back with a potential set of recommendations of what it might look like for these customers. This is really important because I can do like kind of my overall testing pattern of what this is going to look like for my app, especially something called GPT groundness, which is like how accurate is this thing compared to what questions they're asking. Notice here, in this case, a one, which is the lowest one, is one I should pay attention to. There could be something wrong with our prompt flow design or even the model that's being built.
Wow, this is really powerful stuff.
And we got more coming in the future. You saw the code in here is Python-based. So in the future, we'll work with the prompt flow team that the data sources will be directly to your database, and you just type in your query and just go from there.
So you'd just be like, this is my Azure SQL database, this is the
Here's some queries, do it for
me. Python code.
No Python code. And at the end, what's going to happen is you can use other services in Azure to directly embed the chat into your website using this idea.
Wow, that's pretty crazy. It's like Lewis from Azure Cognitive Services and the bot framework has come a long way to get to this with Azure SQL Database.
But the key is it's integrating with my own data in my database itself and giving a rich experience for a customer.
Awesome. Yeah. Amazing. Well, you've blown my mind away already. There can't be more.
I have one more.
Okay.
Kind of a sneak peek at something, a first look at something like a CoPilot.
Oh, been hearing a lot about CoPilots.
Yeah. So, you know, Anna, you know I do a lot of things in performance.
Sure.
And to go try to find out a performance problem, say, for a SQL database on why it's running or you know, waiting, that whole concept, and to drill down into the actual problem could take some time. So I'm going to show you a new experience with CoPilot with SQL Database. I'm going to ask the CoPilot, why is my database performing slowly? The amount of queries I'd have to run to go find just first this answer is pretty difficult. But if I click here and ask it, it knows DMV and diagnostics from my database and quickly produce an answer. It knows here it's a CPU problem, but look how rich this gets. It already knows the top worst performing queries, and it has recommendations for them. Like, for example, here's one that's taking a lot of CPU time because there's no index. Or this one's very hard to know. Here's a query that's showing here that's an anti-pattern query. A query it found that's written, if it was written a different way, would perform much better. So I got right to the heart of the problem. I know exactly what queries are causing the problem, and I know recommendations to solve it in a matter of seconds.
Wow, that's pretty cool.
And it would have taken me minutes, hour to figure this out.
Well, I mean, and you being you, Bob Ward, the SQL Server expert, like you could probably come up with these queries and diagnose this in maybe minutes or 30 minutes or something. But like for a lot of folks who maybe aren't as familiar, like this could take a really long time and now they just did it faster than you could do it.
I don't know about faster than I can do it. Yeah, we'll see about that, actually.
And then I also know to give some training recommendations.
Oh, from Bob Ward.
Bob Ward.
Yeah, maybe it's possible that I help train this model
like
on some of my knowledge.
Bring in Bob Ward into CoPilot. I like it.
The Bob CoPilot?
I need Bob in my pocket.
Oh, my gosh, that's a scary thing. I got one more thing to show you.
Okay.
So you know about the new GitHub CoPilot experience in Azure Data Studio very well, which is kind of like a auto prompt thing.
Sure.
But I'm going to show you something different here. This is something new. I'd like to go tell CoPilot just to build the whole query at one time. Like this is like a natural language to SQL experience. So I'm just going to tell CoPilot here, if you put in here, here's my comment. I want you to just generate the whole thing. And you look at this description, this may not be a trivial thing to write. In fact, look at the query that it generates. This is like a common table expression, which even the most deepest T-SQL experts could take some time to build this out correctly. It knows my schema, Anna. It knows the my table organization, my relationships, my keys, is able to put this together, and I can run the query and get the results. Do you know how much a time saving this is? This is really incredible. So this is like the next evolution of helping build SQL queries for experts, kind of like you see today in GitHub Copilot. This is just the next future of what we're doing.
Cool, amazing. So Bob, as we close out, like, where can people go to learn more and what's coming?
Right, so we've got a lot. This is just the tip of the iceberg. If you look at the right-hand corner here, this is a new website, a new documentation site for all the work we're doing on SQL AI. And you know Davide, right? You got to bring Davide back on. Davide is working on vector searching. Davide is working on how to use write applications with SQL to use vector searching to build rich generative AI applications. And there's even more with Agnative Cognitive Search we're working on to combine with SQL. So this is just the start for us. Look more in the future for more to come.
Awesome, cool. Well, Bob, thanks so much for joining us today. For our viewers, thanks for tuning in. If you like this episode, go ahead, give it a like, leave us a comment, and let us know what your favorite thing we're doing in the AI space is. And we hope to see you next time on Data Exposed.